we have an chicken.
How's it going, guys? This is the chicken I just started, 15 minutes. So I hope whoever's cooking have put their chicken in the oven. We got some skin on here, thighs, and I just did some breasts too. I think Morgan did a little post, hello, of what we seasoned it with. This is actually a dish that growing up, my dad really, he did like three dishes. He did a chili, this dish, and then a stew or spaghetti. So four dishes. I wanted to tweak it. I did the obayata sauce. We did a jollof rice one day. And so it is traditionally, he does it with only tomato sauce, and you can do spaghetti sauce if you want. But this one, I'm gonna add some jollof rice, obayata sauce, seasoning rather. And we're gonna test out that. It's really delicious. I've been trying it here and there. Yesterday, actually, is my first time, but it's really good. So we had this in the oven for 15 minutes. We want to get the skin nice and crispy, and then we'll cook the whole dish kind of together with some in the sauce. But we can leave this in the oven for another 15 minutes to cook a little bit more, and I'll turn it down probably like 350 or something like that. What did you have them cooking it at, Morgan?
400.
400. How's everyone doing today? Who's here?
We have Lisa Hernandez. We've got
Hello.
Gwenny. We've got Brian. We have we also have Jennifer, and everybody says hello. So
hello, welcome. Thank you for coming. So I'll do the quick little veggies. We'll cut up some veggies and we'll put them in our saucepan. I'm gonna turn it to medium high right now. Medium low rather, sorry. We'll just do some onions, and we can do this with the sweet little peppers, or we can do it with bell peppers. I just like some color, so we do this. And then some mushrooms and some black olives. If you don't like black olives, I would use Kalamata. Would use this, but wouldn't be too great using any other olive, I don't think. So, which Andersons are on? Gwen?
Who? Yeah, you got Gwen and Jen.
Gwen and Jen? Hello, Gwen and Jen.
And you got Lisa. Becky. Becky Bach just got on.
Cool. I don't know if this is Whole30 friendly. It actually, I'm doing rice, so you can use something else. But it's served over rice traditionally. Well, traditionally as in my dad. And he uses a different seasoning on it. But for the jollof rice, it's really good with the paprika and some other seasoning, like the salt and pepper and Italian seasonings. How's everybody's weekend? I'm waiting to hear something. I'm like,
you're waiting to hear it.
Nobody's gonna talk.
No, but what'd you do this weekend?
What did we do?
Yeah.
We went to Portland for a couple days. Kids got a little break. We got a little weekend break for 2 days. It was very nice. Thanks, Haggerty's, for having us.
Ooh, Discover Lincoln hiked in the mountains.
Ooh, nice. What did you do, Morgan?
What did I do? I went and got pampered this weekend.
So I like pretty fairly big dices here and slices, because we're gonna saute them and then we're gonna cover them sauce. So they're gonna all cook down in the oven on the stovetop. So
this is not time for your fancy dicing. This is time to just chop it to get it in sauce.
Yeah. We put that on the oven here in a little olive oil. And then we'll mix in some sausages.
And we've got 2 cans of tomato sauce. These are diced cans, or diced tomatoes and tomato juice, and then the black olives, like you said.
We'll put the black olives in a little bit later. And this is that obeata sauce. If you saw my, was it on my story? Or was it on?
It was a post.
It was a post, okay. So this is already cooked down obeata sauce. It has habanero in it. It has shallots. It has onions. Tomatoes, red onion, and I think that's bell pepper too. Yeah, bell pepper in it as well. So we'll put 1 scoop of that into 2, depending on our heat profile. If we like a little hotter, we put some chili flakes, red pepper chili flakes in the on the chicken, and then we'll see kind of afterwards what your preference is. You can even top it with some cheese too, a little bit later, if you like to serve it with some cheese. Saute the veggies here for a couple minutes. Saute, and we'll put the sauce right over it. We'll saute that. We'll cook that down a little bit, and then we'll finish it all off in the oven. So we're gonna go to the drink making after this, because really it's gonna be oven top and stove top is only gonna be about 10 minutes. Oven time is probably gonna be about 20. So
what's the question?
I don't have a question. The Haggertys had somebody over. They had guests.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That.
What's our drink today?
A margarita. Don't back up here.
So, when I worked at Volterra, so the salt and boca dish that we made was not from there, but it was a dish they made all the time. So I figured I was like, might as well do a popular drink from there too. As well as the popular dish that we did. So this was a really simple, you know how to make a margarita, and you top it with some Chianti. That's their version. Mine is a little different. If you have a salt, and then we sometimes put a little bit of cinnamon on there for dust the rim with some salt and cinnamon. It gives a little more a little more sweet profile that I like. We have tequila.
And we had, Josh says he's sorry he's late, but he's following along cooking.
Oh, you are?
And this is obeata chicken. So the sauce that we're using as the base is the obeata Nigerian sauce. That's the same sauce that's used in the jollof rice dish that he cooked.
We can go see what Josh is doing if you want to zoom in on Josh and share.
Yeah, Josh, if you want to join our screen, you're more than welcome to.
See what you're cooking, see how it's going. In the meantime, I'll get back to the tequila. You let me know in a minute. So we just used the Casadores Reposado, some triple sec, and then lime juice. If you don't want to juice some lime, we got a great 365 from Whole Foods. Already fresh, no sugar in there or anything. Salted rim, a little cinnamon on there if you like. You can garnish this with a blood orange, or not a blood orange, but an orange slice would be nice. We didn't have any, but I just really love the color. This is a drink I kind of make for Brian whenever we see him. Because it's super nice, it's summery, it's simple. But it was just really popular over there, and so figured, hey, might as well tell some other people about it. It was made by, originally those drinks were all made by Kathy Casey. I think it is copyright or something like that, so but I'm making a Kathy Casey drink. She makes delicious drinks. So
He said he was following and cooking. He didn't mention anything.
I was like, this one's gonna go by really fast.
You got some drool face emojis for your drink.
So we're gonna do, this is like my rough estimate of like a 3/4 cup here. And then a whole can of that. Based on the amount of chicken I had, we're cooking enough to feed four people. So, you know, you can double this recipe or you can reduce it in half. The variation here is, once again, the obeyata sauce. We're gonna do two healthy portions of that to bring a little bit more flavor there and a little bit more heat.
Once and again, to help you reuse your leftovers.
Yeah, this is a Nigerian, you know, meets Italian. So, and like I said, we can finish this off in the stove right now if we wanted to, or we can simmer it down a little bit more here. I'm gonna check our chicken because we need to turn it down here pretty soon. Yeah, so we'll turn it down. So it's at 375. We'll turn it down to 300. I might even pour off some of those chicken juices if I don't want to have it in the sauce. And I'll save that for, I won't save that. Could use it if I wanted to, but I may not. And all I have left to do is put some little fresh olives in there. And then, like I said, we'll garnish it with some cheese if we want. But hang tight. I'm going to get those olives and then we're going to pour it all together.
What's in the sauce?
The, which one?
This, is the obeyata sauce or the?
So, to answer both questions, the sauce in there is a mixture of tomato sauce, diced tomatoes, and then obeyata sauce, which is, in that it's blended up bell peppers, onions, habanero, some other things. It's on my post. You can take a look at it. It was just a dish that I learned a couple weeks back and I really love it. So we did a jollof rice with that. And we went ahead and featured it again.
We used
it was
so leftovers.
Great. Yeah. You can freeze it we froze it for up to 2 weeks. Pull the chicken out. So we got, who's our?
Well, you've had people add since you've, Wesley's here.
Oh.
Joel Smith joined.
Hello, guys.
I'm probably missing someone. If I'm missing somebody, I apologize.
Did everybody at least get the drink so far? How to make the drink?
Or at least hopefully they're enjoying their own drink.
Margarita, add some Chianti on it. Super simple.
It just looks pretty.
Yeah. It's pretty. Brian makes them all the time now. So. Alrighty. So we'll put the, I just like the skin's crispy. I'll put the sauce all around and I can cover it if you want to cook it longer and lower. Or you can just leave it uncovered and cook it for probably another 20 or so. But obviously check your chicken. You know, you don't want to get sick. We'll season it with some more fresh herbs on the top as well. We got Wesley and Lisa, two from Arizona in.
Lori Brownell's here too. So you've got multiple people from Arizona. Arizona's representing themselves today.
Yeah. Nice.
We've got Nebraska.
Discover Lincoln.
Yep.
Cool.
And then Becky Block, she's Mexico.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Cool. I had, what was it? We had Australia a while back?
We did have Australia a while back.
Nice. Cool. So that's about there. We won't cover it because, I don't care to cover it. But we have a little rice that we just cooked. Oh, I was gonna ask, there's anybody have any Instapot desires? We just recently got an Instapot and we're gonna experiment with it. So if you know any good recipes or wanna make some good things, message us. But yeah, we're gonna, when it's done, obviously we put put the rice on the bottom, put some chicken over it, and eat and enjoy. This will be another 20 minutes. How big are your chicken thighs, Josh? Because ours were, they were like this thin, not thin, but that thick, a little bit wider. And so, you know, like I just cook mine for maybe, total time was probably about 30 minutes because I did 15 and then
lowered the temperature.
Lowered the temperature 15 and we'll probably cook it after 10 extra minutes just to be safe. But obviously we can check it with a thermometer or cut into it. Oh wow, that's a super short one. Tell me a joke, someone.
Well, my phone might die if we go for too much longer.
Okay. Well, I would obviously, if it was a video, I'd just fast forward time, show you the finished product, have a little bite, but we can't do that today. So,
I'll take a video of him and post it on our story of him taking the first bite.
There you go. If you have any questions, you can always message. This was, once again, jollof rice sauce, which is obeata sauce, mixed with the chicken Italian dish that my dad used to make, still does, and melded together with some rice from the Instapot. Morgan wants to experience some meals in the Instapot, so give her some suggestions or some ideas, and we'll try to come up with some too. So, thanks so much for coming in, and hope you're having a good drink. We'll see you soon.